8-year-old Ethan is slowly returning to the kid he once was, before the epileptic seizures started when he was just 3 years old.
His seizures were evolving. When he turned 5, he was losing skill set. He was reverting back to crawling, and his vocabulary was declining.
This led the Dieter family on a journey, one that included one of Nebraska's first pediatric stereoelectroencephalographies, or sEEG, an innovative approach much like a traditional EEG, but with the electrodes placed into the brain.
When we do a scalp EEG, we're basically working with interference from the skin, sweat, salts in the sweat, hair.
This one is with electrodes that are placed inside the brain. And so you end up having a much higher accuracy of the signal.
From there, Spria Pavaluri and the neurology team used patient participation to help in real-time mapping of the brain, locating the seizure's origin to within a centimeter.
Rather than saying, let's look north or south or east or west, you're basically saying, let's look at X. And we can draw the map out, we can get to the street, we can get to the house address, and we can say, within the house, it's in this bedroom.
I think sEEG is so neat and useful because it gave us a data point that we weren't capturing until the day we did the sEEG.
This information guided Afshin Salehi and the pediatric neurosurgery team in yet another innovative procedure called Laser Interstitial Thermal Therapy, or LITT, where the team places a fiber optic cable in the area of interest, then connects a laser system and uses real-time imaging to accurately and safely treat the seizure area. In Ethan's case, the hippocampus.
You are able to do this sort of minimally invasive ablative procedure that achieves the same goal as an open procedure, but instead of a large incision, you end up with a 1 centimeter Band-Aid type of incision, and much less pain. And so for Ethan, for example, we did this ablative procedure and he left the next day.
By Ethan's first checkup 2 weeks later, his parents could already see signs of a reduction in seizure burden.
I feel like he's clearer in thought process.
But his writing, even almost immediately, has been so much clearer, smaller, not all over the place. Speech is clear, cautiously optimistic.
That optimism extends to others in the epilepsy community who will benefit from the collaboration and innovation of neurosciences at Children's.
The impact is going to be huge. Now the challenge is going to be, how do we put the word out there? How do we let parents know that, you know, being on 6 medications and suffering every day is not the only option you have?
I mean, the care we've received has been amazing. I mean, I don't know where we'd be going. Can't say enough about that. Just from the whole journey from Dr. Ricard to Dr. Coe, Dr. Salehi, and everybody else, that's kind of a game changer.